When this crew realized what they were seeing, it was nearly too late to escape. The air turned foul. Even the winds wouldn't take the smell away. Everywhere around them, the ground grew thicker and harder to navigate. He prayed it wouldn't damage the already struggling engine, because if they ended up stranded, none of them would make it back home. They'd be lost forever. Fred steered the Mykon over the deep blue crests and troughs of the South Pacific. The rest of his crew, his girlfriend and two friends, enjoyed the hot sun and cool ocean breeze. The day had been a perfect one, but as he looked over the horizon, he noticed something strange. The normal hues of azure and navy had taken on a light earthy tone. He'd seen the similar coloration many times, mostly in sandbars. However, they only appeared close to shore. Filled with curiosity, he steered his boat towards the mysterious formation. Little did he know, that was a bad decision. "It's an island?" he asked. "Can be, it's not on any of the charts," his girlfriend said. Fred sped up, eager to find out what was going on. But as the wind brushed across his face, it brought something new, a horrible smell that made his nose scrunch. Everyone pulled their shirts over their mouths. What happened next was even stranger. As they neared the edge and prepared to bump into shore, the boat cut straight through instead. He looked back to see a dark trail behind them, like a northern boat pushing through snow and ice. By the time he saw his girlfriend leaning over the railing, it was too late. The loud squeak of her body slipping against the boat joined her scream as she fell into the water. Fred ran for the edge, feeling his heart stopped. She thrashed against the strange material floating on the surface. It was like fighting to get out of a thick, grainy bog. Her hand was just out of reach. When they pulled her out of the strange, smelly stew, Fred wrapped his arms around her. "It's all right, I'm okay, my bad," she said, brushing the bits from her clothes. "At least the water's warm." He was about to say they should head out, when one friend pointed overboard and muttered, "Oh my god." Mixed with a growing patch of brown, dead fish popped out and floated on the surface. Was it a toxic waste dump? Had another ship gone done? But then he reached out and took a piece of grit off of his girlfriend. He had seen this before. It was the very first clue to a very bad conclusion. Stone, warm water, dead fish. The details fell into place like falling dominoes, and the truth vibrated in Fred's mind. He also saw that they were right in the middle of it all. "We need to get out of here now!" He scrambled for the wheel, ignoring everyone's questions. He wasn't sure how much time they had, but it probably wasn't much. Fred shoved the throttle to high and the engine revved hard. What was once a small patch of floating fake land had now grown into something enormous. It pushed against the boat and slowed escape. The air grew thick and acrid. "What's that?" his girlfriend yelled. It was black and getting big. A large plume of dark smoke erupted out of the water. The splashes hissed and sent steam billowing towards the heavens. "Underwater volcano," Fred said. It wasn't until they were far away did he dare to slow down. What happened next was equally awe-inspiring as it was terrifying. The others were already taking photos and video, but all he could do was slump into his seat to try and calm his lungs. He watched as the smoke and steam grew into the sky and a dark outline took over the horizon. He and his friends were first-hand witnesses to the birth of a new island. But what was the sandy layer that his girlfriend had tumbled into? Fred tossed a small piece to a friend. "You have some in your bathroom." They looked at him in confusion. "Pumice stone, the kind you scrub your feet with. That volcano spewed it up to the surface. We were sitting right into the middle of it." Another loud explosion shook the air. The volcano cleared its throat again and shot a towering black column into the sky. Stone shot up and then crashed back into the waves like tiny meteors. The group sat silent, watching every moment. When his own nerves had calmed, he dared to go back and get a little closer, but just a little. It truly was amazing and dangerously beautiful. Fred couldn't help but feel very small, not to mention curious about how it would affect the surrounding coasts. He also had a brilliant idea. Maybe they could come back every year to see what would become of the baby island.